once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Way out where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me! Poetry Slam Festival is coming up soon. I'm so psyched.
Poetry what?
Poetry Slam. It's a contest where anyone from the school, cadets, teachers, whoever wants to enter, reads an original poem they wrote.
Ew, poetry. Boring.
Poetry's not boring at all, Eagle. Did I happen to mention that there is a prize for the best poem?
Prize? What prize?
Come on, you guys. I'll show you.
Whoa, look at these. They're so cool.
Yup, just came in. The latest in new space helmet designs.
You mean we get one of these helmets just for writing a poem?
The winning poem gets a helmet.
Well, why didn't you say so? Hey, I'm gonna ace that contest.
Hey, man, I'm a retro rocket.
Yo, I'm the coolest rocket in space.
Yeehaw, partner. Make way for the cosmic cowboy.
Yeah.
What should I write? I don't know anything about poetry.
Well, you could write about your adventures. And speed.
I guess so.
Hey, you're the school rock star. Just strut your stuff.
That's true. I could hit him up with the old za-za-zoom and toss in some za-za-zing for good measure.
What are you gonna write about, Hawk?
I don't know. I've never written a poem before.
Mighty Hawk, the brawny boy of the cosmos.
Yeah, I could write one about being super strong and how I use my strength during missions.
How about you, Robyn?
My poem's gonna be about something I really love. Calculations.
Maybe you could come up with something a little more, zippy.
And a little less math and science-y?
Hey, numbers can be really cool, you guys. Not everything has to be all action all the time.
It won't matter anyway. I've got this thing won already. Za-za-zoo!
Woo-hoo!
I'll show those guys that numbers and calculating really are cool. Math never lies. So, I like to eat pies. It's math that tells me where the stars are.
Is that your poem for the festival?
Pretty cool, huh?
Well, I guess calculating can be cool.
Yeah.
Okay, but how about calculating about something snazzy?
Snazzy? Like what?
Well, hey, you like Saturn's rings, and they're way cool.
Saturn's rings are made of ice. Now, isn't that nice?
Yeah, something more like that.
Dodo, will you kindly cease that infernal racket? I need peace and quiet to write my poem for the festival.
But I always clean the office every...
Can't you see I'm trying to concentrate? Kindly leave.
Oops. Sorry, boss. Okay, I'm out of here. Here I go. Leaving. Get ready to go.
Now!
Toodles. With noodles.
Ah, some peace, finally. My heart soars.
And a supernova is the explosion of a star. It's the largest explosion that takes place in space. After it has completed its burst, it becomes a pulsar and spins rapidly.
Can we see a pulsar through a telescope?
We can, Sparrow. It can be seen through instruments that detect X-rays or radio frequencies.
So a pulsar can be seen through our space visors too?
Oh yes. Here's what they look like.
Oh, cool! Wow.
The spinning pulsar sends out rotating beams of rays, which we see as pulses of light. You might even say a pulsar has rhythm.
Welcome to this year's Poetry Slam Festival, a night when each of us has the opportunity to extol the beauty of the universe. Allow me to introduce our judges for tonight's competition. Representing the teachers, Coot. Representing the students, Cadet Crow. And I have the honor of representing the school's administration. And now, here to open the festivities, is the chairman of our school board.
Woo-hoo! Hooray for Mr. Vulture!
My poem is called My Heart. My heart soars, rises to the cosmos, greets the stars, which welcome my heart with their twinkling arms. And as the moon shows its luminous face to the mighty cosmos, my heart soars. The cosmic story that is my gloriously soaring heart. Dull-witted school.
Vulture, I was deeply moved by your poem. I never realized you possess such sensitivity.
Why, thank you.
I think you'll enjoy my poem, too. Majestic as the purple skies of Titan, my heart swells for you. Well then, ta-ta for now.
Did you hear that, Dodo? Sandpiper was so enraptured by my poem, she's written a romantic ode to me. I believe she even has feelings for me.
I wouldn't jump to conclusions, boss.
I must respond in kind. Oh, dear Sandpiper, I shall write an ode to our special bond.
And now, please welcome Cadet Raven.
My poem is called Racing. Space is the place for this raven to race. It's the hippest sign when this rocket's flying.
Robyn, are you leaving before you recite your poem?
I'll never be hip and cool like Raven and the others.
I may as well get some homework done.
And that's why I race real high.
Thank you, Cadet Raven. And now, please welcome Cadet Eagle.
Hey, guys. My poem is called Flying. And I've got a bang-up finish, too. Flying fast is just the best. It's lots more fun than a history test.
Splendid, Sandpiper. Your eyes are like the twin moons of Mars, shining in the night. And we, together, shall dance in their light. The splendid, sumptuous, sublime, twinkling light of night. Dodo, I must return to the festival. So, will you take this and slip it under Sandpiper's door? She will thrill to my admiration when she arrives home, I'm sure.
And that's why speed is the thrill, speed is the bomb!
Thank you, Cadet Eagle, for an exhilarating performance. And now, please welcome our intrepid explorer and faculty member, Sandpiper.
Majestic as the purple skies of Titan, my heart swells for you, O Nebula. Sight of wonder and awe.
Why, her poem is not about me at all. It's about a nebula? Did you slip my poem under Sandpiper's door?
Yep, just like you told me to, boss. What'd I say? What'd I say?
You put the whole thing under her door?
Well, isn't that what you...
Out of my way! This is your fault. You must fix it and find a way inside, or I will be ruined. There. Squeeze through that window.
Here you are. We've been looking all over for you.
Yeah, you missed Eagle's poem. He was terrific.
Sorry I missed it, but I'm trying to get some homework done.
Aren't you going to read your poem at the festival?
You guys were all so great up there. And my poem was, you know, about math and calculations. Hey, there's a pulsar, just like we learned in class. Here, have a look.
Wow, look at her go.
Blink, 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 blink. Hey, that's it.
What's it?
Rhythm. Sandpiper said pulsars have rhythm. Well, a math egghead like me can have rhythm too.
Hey, wait for us.
Thank you, Cadet Starling, for that delightful poem. The judges will now confer and announce the winner.
Am I too late to read my poem?
As a wise rocket once said, better late than never. So take it away, Cadet Robyn!
Calculations. I'm gonna win this, cause math and science are always my business. Numbers don't lie, they can be counted on, so I gather data all day long. Other folks, they're just telling jokes. Me, I hit the telescopes, see the stars, Venus or Mars. My rhymes are bumping, just like these pulsars.
Woo! All right, Robyn!
I love going on missions with my awesome friends. I love viewing Saturn through an optical lens. Its seven rings are incredible, unforgettable. I'd take a bite out of them if they were edible. This rocket sure knows how to rock it. The contest is in my pocket.
By unanimous vote, the winner of the Poetry Slam is Cadet Robyn!